Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the Google Analytics components for within the SSIS Productivity Pack product. The SSIS Productivity Pack is a collection of premium SSIS components which enable greater developer productivity and increases the power of SSIS. As of this recording, the SSIS Productivity Pack offers two Google Analytics components: Google Analytics Connection Manager and Google Analytics Source. The Connection Manager can be used to establish connections with Google Analytics. The Source component can be used to read or retrieve data from Google Analytics. Let's begin by creating our Google Analytics Connection Manager. Right-click on the Connection Manager area down below to add a new connection. Select the Google Analytics item to add this new Connection Manager. Once you give authorization, Google Analytics retrieves tokens from the Google app. The tokens are stored in registry so that once they expire, our component will automatically request new tokens from Google and replace the existing tokens with the new ones in registry to minimize user effort. You have two options to choose where in the registry you would like to store these tokens: local machine or current user. The Update Token button completes the entire OAuth authentication process inside of the toolkit. All you need to do is log into Google and authorize our app to generate your Google Analytics tokens. The Account ID is an integer number that uniquely represents your account. You would need to make sure you have tokens created. To create your tokens, select Update Token button. All existing account IDs will be listed in the dropdown. The account name will show the name of your Google account. The next section for Google Analytics API authorization information has two options, provided by KingswaySoft or using your own application registration with Google. If the provided by KingswaySoft option is selected, the components will use a client ID and secret that is provided by KingswaySoft for your convenience. It's important to note that this should never be used for production purposes. If you'd like to use your own application registration with Google, select the My Own option. To obtain your own Google Analytics API authorization credentials, please follow the instructions in the provided link here. Let's head to the Advanced Settings page. You can configure proxy server settings if a proxy is required. There are a few options in the miscellaneous section. The timeout option allows you to specify a timeout value in seconds for the connection. The default value is 120 seconds. The API throttling rate is based on the throttle limits in Google Analytics. This rate is set to 10 requests per second by default to respect the Google Analytics API throttle limit. There is also an option for retry and intermittent errors. This option is intended to help recover from possible intermittent outages or disruption of service so that the integration does not have to be stopped due to temporary networking issues. We have designed this option so that it should only retry when it's deemed to be safe to do so, but there may be exceptions. Before we hit OK, we should test the connection to make sure our information is correct and we can connect successfully. Please note that the connection manager that we just created is a package-level connection manager. For SSIS 2012 or later, you can create project-level connection managers if you right-click the connection manager's node within the Solution Explorer. Let's begin by configuring our Dataflow task, starting with our Google Analytics source component, and drag it to the design surface. Double-click to open its editor form. As mentioned before, the Google Analytics source component is an SSIS Dataflow pipeline component that can be used to read and receive data from Google Analytics. Let's select a Google Analytics Connection Manager. The Analytics View option specifies the Google Analytics view to select. Click the Eclipse button to open up a Google Analytics web profile dialog to select a view. The Metadata Mode dropdown contains a list of commonly used queries in Google Analytics. Each mode indicates a configuration that defines a combination of metrics, dimensions, filters, and sort parameters, so you can select and use them directly. The date range option allows you to specify a date range to retrieve data from Google Analytics. The date value can be for a specific date period by using the datetime picker controls, or can be selected from the drop-down list, which contains several predefined date ranges. The metrics option allows you to specify the metrics from Google Analytics. The dimensions option allows you to specify the dimensions to break down the metrics you specified. This option is optional. The sort by option contains a list of metrics and dimensions, indicating the sorting order for the returned data. You can specify the sorting fields and directions so the results will be sorted. This option is optional. The segment option allows you to choose segment in Google Analytics from the dropdown. This option is optional. The sampling mode option specifies a sampling level to query data from Google Analytics. There are three types: default, faster, and higher precision. The page size option allows you to specify how many records you want to retrieve each time. If the include empty rows option is disabled, rows where all the metric values are zero will be omitted. This option is enabled by default. Navigating to the filters page, this will allow you to build the filter condition when retrieving data from Google Analytics. The metrics filters grid allows you to specify the filtering conditions for metrics. The dimensions filters grid allows you to specify the filtering conditions for dimensions. The filters option shows a filter query that is auto-generated by the metrics filters and dimension filters. Let's head to the columns page where we can see all available fields from the metrics and dimensions specified on the general page. When a field is selected, its properties window show more detailed information accordingly. Let's click OK to finish configuring our source component. For this demonstration, we are going to add a dummy data reader destination component for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to destination components. We can now execute this task. This concludes a demonstration of the Google Analytics components within our SSIS Productivity Pack. There are many other components in the SSIS Productivity Pack that enable developers to accomplish more in SSIS in a much more productive fashion. Google Analytics is just one of the Google services that is supported in our SSIS product family. We also have support for Google AdWords, with potentially more Google services to come. Please feel free to take a look at our other videos available for viewing on our website or YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.